All right, everybody, welcome to home workout number 4. Today, we're going to do a little bit of lateral agility work, some strength work, some stretching, some core work. We're going to start with something called crossover steps. So we're going to start in a nice, good athletic position here, knees bent, chest up. We're going to swing our arms, and we're going to cross that knee across your body and land in a nice, good position here, okay? We're going to test that out. We're going to make sure we got some balance when we do that, and then we're going to go back. Once we feel good with that, we're going to start going faster. Cross, cross, thinking about taking that knee and kneeing somebody right next to you as hard as you can as you go through, stopping, going through the other one as many times as you can, as fast as you can for 15 seconds. You're going to rest for 30 seconds and repeat that 10 times. We'll take a little break. We're going to move on to number 2. We're going lateral bounds. We're going to stand on one leg. We are going to jump as far as we can to the side and land on our opposite leg. Stick that landing. Swing those arms. We're going back the other side. Hold. Hold. Thinking about bending that knee. Rotating over that front leg and landing nice and soft the entire time, trying to keep that balance. You're going to go 5 times each leg. Stop. Take a rest. Repeat 3 times. So 3 rounds. 5 times each leg. Next jump, we're going to go what's called a single leg hop. We're going to start on our right leg, okay? On our right leg, we are going to jump to the left, and we are going to land on our right leg. Then we're going to go back to the right on our right leg. 5 times each way on your right leg, and then 5 times each way on your left leg. Stop, take a break, repeat 3 times, all right? Now, going back to what we did a couple days ago, right? We're going to go back to our split squats, and we're going to go back to our push-up negatives, right? So, again, just a reminder, split squats, okay? Keeping that front leg forward, hands out in front of you. We're going down nice and slow, okay? Up nice and slow, keeping our weight on that front leg. Imagine that back foot is on ice, all right? And you don't want to break that ice, so we don't want to have a lot of weight on that back foot, keeping everything over that front leg. Straight up, straight down, just like an elevator, not like an escalator, okay? We're going to go 10 times each leg, and then we are going to switch. Or 10 times, switch to the other leg. Then we're going to rest, and we're going to pair that with a push-up negative, all right? So as a reminder, our push-up negatives are going to be a little bit different than our regular push-ups, okay? Our push-up negatives, we are going to only go down. We are not going to worry about pushing ourselves up. We're going to start up in a push-up position, and we're going to control 5-1000, 4-1000, 3-1000, 2-1000, 1-1000, all the way to the ground, pop myself back up, and repeat. We are going to go 5 times, 5 seconds each, okay? Nice and slow. What I want you to avoid here, what I want you to be careful of, is as we go slow, we like to have those hips drop and flare those elbows. We like to have that head go towards the ground. I don't want any of that. I want to see one straight line from the top of your head to the bottom of your heels. All right, and that is going to be your push-up negatives. We'll do 5 of those. So we're going to pair those split squats and those push-up negatives, 10 each side for your split squats, paired with 5 push-up negatives. We'll repeat that 3 to 5 times. All right, after that, we're going back to those shoulder taps, right? We went our shoulder taps the other day. Same thing. We want to make sure that we are in a good push-up position. Right? My hands are under my shoulders. My feet are nice and wide. I'm going to touch my right hand to my left shoulder. Imagine there's a full glass of water on my lower back and not letting that water spill, right? We don't want to be rotating side to side. Nice and easy, nice and slow. If you need to make that easier for yourself, widen those feet up even more. And you see it'll be easier to keep yourself nice and still. All right. And we're finishing up again with our hip stretch. All right, on one knee, both arms to the sky, driving those hips forward, stretching those hips out. If you want to make that challenging and get a little bit of a better stretch, you can even try to grab onto something here, hold onto that back leg, and rock forward and backwards. You just feel a nice stretch in the front of that hip, and you will be good to go. All right, want to keep those hips nice and loose. Hey, we're at home all day. We're probably sitting a lot more than we're used to. We got to make sure we're keeping those hips nice and loose for you, okay? So we'll go 3 times, or 3 rounds, 10 times each way for your shoulder taps, and then 2 or 3 rounds, 10 times each way for those hip flexor stretches, rocking back and forth, okay? So to recap, we are starting with our crossover steps. We're moving into those lateral bounds. We are then going into our lateral hops on each leg, pairing up our split squats and our push-up negatives, then into our shoulder taps, and finally, cooling down with a nice hip flexor stretch. So workout for today. Good luck, everybody. Work hard. Have fun.